Dear Toastmasters, I am Toastmaster Deepak Joseph, Business Manager of Arms for Meeting number 157. 158 of Toastmasters, Mustafa Toastmasters Club. The mission of Toastmasters Club is to provide a supportive and positive learning experience in which the members are empowered to develop communication and leadership skills, resulting in greater self-confidence and personal growth. As a protocol of Toastmasters International, you are requested to keep away from three taboo topics, that is, sex, politics, and religion, during your speech. Further, I request every one of you to switch off your mobile phones or put them in silent mode during the meeting to avoid distraction. Also, you are requested to be seated, sit comfortably until you are called. With this note, I invite our President of Toastmasters, Rajesh Palikare, to bless our opening address.
Now we are
seven.
Now we are. So a lot of these books. talking about reduced tower. The numbers, because of many reasons, situations, we said that always in the office also if we check, at least 10% of the employees on vacations. That is one thing. Second, 10% already comes are not there in the office. Another 20% they are always busy. It is not like earlier. Out of the 50%, we need to find the account. And one good thing is that if this meeting could have been other than something like Toastmasters here, today maybe the outcome will be similar to what we were supposed to work on. Because in Toastmasters, when we take up your role, there is a commitment behind that. If there is a commitment, whatever is the situation, we are forced to come and attend and execute that perfectly. That's what we learn in Toastmasters. Let us energize ourselves with a big round of applause again. Toastmaster Dinesh, I am considering you as a guest today. Is there any problem?
No.
Because when I told him, today, he told, I could see from the trend itself, predictive analytics. Because last, after announcing the last meeting, I didn't see him anywhere commenting or saying in the WhatsApp, no responses. Then I understood he is not here to turn up. Still I called him, in case if he is coming up, let me give him a roll. He told, sorry, I am preparing for an examination, very big examination, that is profession. Then I told, oh, that is first, don't come. Still, why you are coming? Why did you come?
Because I don't know, my car,
again, that is the commitment and the affinity and attitude towards.
This is not commitment, it is intoxication.
Okay. I won't use that word, still, it is a commitment. But. And in extinguishable commitment. Yeah. Yes. Now, what we will do, we will just. Spend our time as a casual meeting, but without losing formalities. There are some changes in the agenda. Sitting down, you can take the agenda and make the corrections. Meeting to order, sitting down, Deepak Joseph Molinon took up the role. Welcome, please. Okay, then.
Yes,
our counter. Our counter. Our desk end.
Yes.
Okay, there you go. Toastmaster Dinesh. Come on. Any topics? Questions? Not yet. Is there? Next correction is Toastmaster. I didn't fill up. I couldn't get the person, catch up the person. Now, the Toastmaster Rajesh Padikari will be taking up the Toastmaster. Prepared speeches, unfortunately, this will be one of the meeting very sparingly, right? We used to conduct without a prepared speech. But fortunately, Toastmaster Rajesh Padikari, our president, will be repeating his one of already delivered projects. Let us encourage him with that.
Let us evaluate
that.
SCP, this one, advanced project.
Okay. Let us evaluate. Who is going to run?
Advanced project.
Yeah.
AC B or AC?
B.
AC B 3. AC B 3. Project number 3. Cosmos Dinesh?
Yeah.
Do you have the courage to evaluate that?
Yes.
Okay. Very good. Cosmos Dinesh. It is yours, sir. It is yours. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Very good.
Very much
okay.
So, accountant?
Accountant, accountant who?
I'll make it. I have to take it over to it.
Yeah, I love that you can take it. Okay, I'm repeating. Secretary Deepak Joseph. Accountant Deepak Joseph again. Table book is already there. Kiss Master Rajesh Palikare. Rajesh Palikare is doing his repeating his SME question number 3, and Toastmaster Dinesh will be evaluating the speech. Right, now we are in full quorum in terms of the agenda. Okay, let me start. Okay, for that. But only one limitation, I didn't expect that we need to have a projector actually. Next. No, not okay. Except that we cannot connect, so I'll try to that. Are you all aware of the expansion, or what is the meaning of the term which I mentioned in the as the team of the SMO?
Are
you aware of IoT? No, the Internet of Things. Right. Internet of Things.
Internet of?
Yeah. Internet of Things.
Things.
Things. Internet of Things. This is, you might think this one as a technology or techie oriented term, but it is going to be a part of our everyday life. Not in the far future, very near. It is there with us. It is going to be increasing exponentially day by day its presence. Just before, just it's like some terminologies and some names today I will tell you. I'm sure that is going to be a valuation for your current business. If you are not that familiar with this technology, at some point of time, in another couple of years, we all will be bounded to Internet of Things. Let me just tell you the abstract of one video. I'm going to show you that would have been more impressive. Still, I will tell you the abstract of that small video. It is just telling about a scenario wherein one person who is working in Abu Dhabi in some XYZ tower, he is sitting in the 10th floor in his office. He has his corporate office in Dubai, say tomorrow tower. It is 10 o'clock. They were doing conference by connecting Dubai across the world. Dubai corporate office plus his client office in Abu Dhabi, other 2-3 office locations in Middle East, in other GCC countries. They were in between, suddenly a suggestion came, Mr. Rajesh, we could come up out to Dubai. We need to go and meet the client here. Okay. Normally, in the generic situations, what would happen? It is 10 o'clock. Mr. Rajesh would say, today I have a lot of commitments. If at all I am ready, then it will take another bilateral action, I will be able to come over there. But to the Dubai level, they will meet the client urgently, say, in 1 hour time. if we are in a perfectly IoT oriented ecosystem, terminology ecosystem comes there. In an IoT oriented ecosystem, automatically, as soon as they decide, like, okay, you are going to Bushrakesh, come down to Dubai by 11 o'clock, automatically, without having, he will not call anybody, he will not call the car, he will not call his assistants, he will not reschedule anything. Their collaborative dashboards and their cooperative schedules will be automatically getting rearranged, and in 5 minutes down the line, a cab will be coming down to pick him. That is an autonomous car. Without a driver, will be coming and dropping him where? To a train system wherein this capsule, wherever he is entering into, will be automatically getting connected to a hub, wherein he will be automatically pushed into a capsule, and that will be reaching Dubai in 10 minutes. The same thing will repeat. Therefore, that capsule will be linked to an autonomous car wherein he will be immediately reaching down tomorrow at all. And that is not the end. Throughout this travel, he will not be getting disturbed physically. He will be continuing the conference with all media around without losing any kind of connectivity, no disturbances. This is a particular scenario I have gone through when I saw that video, which was shown as a part of one meeting which I attended. Lot of components are involved in this. Autonomous car, that capsule getting connected, rescheduling, connected to how he can reach Dubai in Tumitomni in 10 minutes time. That is going to be with the Hyperloop you have heard of, right? It is not something which is visualizing. What is going on and is going to happen using Hyperloop? We can arrange there, and that's all technology which is linked to this particular tech. That's what I wanted to say. And how about the money factor? Again, I said automatically the car will come, no driver, driver, no waiting him, there also. There is no human, no humanized, it's not humanized. That is another terminology linked to this IoT, that is blockchain. You may not have heard of this blockchain, but recently there is another term which is getting coined up, that is Bitcoin. Okay. Actually, the basic terminology related to Bitcoin is blockchain. Okay. All these are terms and terminologies we are going to be a part of our life, not more than 3 years. Okay. I will repeat these terms when I explain.
Suppose we all have access to those kind of things, and you are the boss of the company where all of us are working.
Okay.
So you can decide our movements if we give access to the power.
Okay.
So
I can control it. Okay, that's the difference. When I spoke about these things, I told there is no human. Humanized automation will be tailing to things-oriented automation. Their preference may not be with the boss or human. Okay? that system will decide based on its intelligence, priorities, predictions, situations, sensing, sensations. If all combine together, it will decide and reject what is going to be the next action. That is the way of intelligence the system is going to end. Okay? Maybe, of course, there will be a supercurrency. Humanized operations can be. Let's say this is automatically getting rescheduled and the boss say, don't come. There can be a trigger. But the advantage is, before pressing the trigger or deciding on whether the strategy is going to come or not, overriding factors, he will be getting a dashboard or analytics. Okay, if you don't come, what is the impact? If you come, what is the impact? Maybe when Ramesh is there, he'll be gaining the project. Otherwise, he need to count the lost opportunity cost. Well, these are things, see, this is the way we can visualize the situations. Okay, probably it's good. Okay, yes. Now, let us, let me introduce the players, all among us, all our players here today. Toastmaster Deepak Joseph is the subject for us today. He is handling the role of accountant. What else?
Webmaster.
And webmaster Grammarian. Multiple roles. Let us again give them a big round of applause. And Toastmaster Deepak Joseph, he all of us know what is his profession, where he is working, right? He works for BB, right? Bureau Veritas. Bureau Veritas is a certification, right? Company. And he is coming from the petroleum, right? Graduation in petroleum.
Indian
oil and gas. He is working for the company. Which company? It's executive in Bureau Veritas. Yes. I have a question. Can you tell me what is written as a comment in your LinkedIn page? LinkedIn
comment. Page.
Yeah, about you. Do you remember?
Status.
Not the status. Some comments we used to add. You also I took from there only.
Like I think it was by Samsung Telco.
Not from this site. In our profile, we used to mention, okay, I am so and so, so and so, so and so, so ambitious, so good in that.
Right.
You don't remember, huh?
No, I didn't.
Okay.
Yes, we wrote to get the topic we
used. Yeah. Okay. Can I invite you to? What is this? Yes. Yeah. Try to read it out.
Okay. Greetings, everyone. Technology always fascinates me and I am always in search to learn new things. I believe a day where learning or valuation is nil is a day wasted. Curiosity drives me, self-motivation, energetic, ambitious and a very good team player and highly
good. That's you.
That's my LinkedIn profile summary.
Okay. But the good thing is, he wrote this and we can see where by where he is applying that. Right? Motivated or fascinated and what well located to technology. Okay, at least read your profile.
That is
what
others
can
all right.
Yeah. Then, when we write something in our Facebook or some other media, I check it. Okay? sometimes it will be outdated, sometimes someone will be asking and we are assessing based on this and suddenly it will be something, it will be blank like this, even for me it's same. Okay. Alright.
Is this our Yes. Just answer is just tell my mistake is what is act.
Right. Now timer. Let us introduce welcome our timer. Timer Toastmaster Way Vijayapan. After long our senior Toastmaster is taking up that road and he is there since around 7:45. Okay, another Toastmaster. Okay, Toastmaster Way Vijayapan. You know, I am also trying to write it because at least we should not forget our colleagues, the profession or where he is working. Like Dr. Devas Joseph, you know, is a PV now. Now, Vivek Ayyappan, all of us know, right? He is a
great
yes. He is the, now you are not India Secretary, right? Now you are the procurement manager.
Procurement
officer. Procurement officer in Blue Ocean Purchasing for. That is different.
That is for
what is the current union?
Union
Iron and Steel Company. Yes.
That is the area secretary for the forum.
Earlier?
Area secretary for the forum.
Oh, that's another forum.
Okay. Forum.
So can I read out your qualifications? Only your LinkedIn profile or what? Okay. So he is working as sales. Procurement officer in Union Iron and Steel Company. Not only that, as far as I know, he is an entrepreneur. You know that? So, yes, he's so convincing. Right? Since from?
Just 1 year before.
Oh, not 1 year. Okay, because he's holding one of the best job models. Okay. See, understand that the study is useful to work with us. Now the evaluator comes, the Toastmaster Rashid. No.
health
safety
is digital. Right, says the security manager for this Cisco company. Let us welcome him also. Anyone has an impromptu thought for today?
Yes.
Okay. Let us welcome. Toastmaster Devesh will be taking up the role of thought of the day. Okay. Now let me call upon the role players. Toastmaster Vivek Ayyappan. Can you introduce your role for today?
Good evening, everybody, once again.
Good evening.
My role as a timer is to monitor time during speeches, table topics, evaluations. At the end of the meeting, I will report the time of each participant. This will let you know if you delivered your presentation within the allotted time frame. Over to you. Thank you.
Toastmaster Deepak, can you explain about your role today?
Good evening, Toastmasters. Good evening. As an operator, I will be checking about during speech and evaluation. I will be checking about the usage of filler words like during the speeches, and the detailed report will be given towards the end of the meeting. Over to you.
In the meantime, you can introduce your where for.
Now I will explain the responsibilities of the grammarian and the word master. One of the objectives of Toastmasters Club meeting is to improve the grammar and the usage of words. So I will be monitoring the usage of grammar during the speeches throughout the meeting. As well as I am introducing a new word to you. Today's word of the day is inextricable. I think it is quite new to everyone over here. To make it simple and easy to understand, the meaning of the word is impossible to disentangle or separate. You know, like the word extract is to separate, is to take something out of each other. So inextricable is inextractable, similar to inextractable. It is something similar to not separate. So the usage of the word can be like, an example is, the past and the present are inextricable. Or related to the theme of the day, the things in Internet of Things is an inextricable mixture of hardware, software, data, and services. The synonyms, that means that it has words which has the same meanings, are inseparable, impossible to separate, indivisible, entangled, etc. It also has another meaning, impossible to escape. So now I request everyone who is delivering the speech during the meeting to abundantly use the word inextricable for delivering the speech. Over to you.
It's very easy to remember inextricable, the term inextricable. If you, you notice the poster which I sent yesterday, there I have given a symbol of two rings. Okay? But anyways, actually, this slide. Once we note, it's inextricable. So the relation between slide, the term, this term is always used whenever something is there. So there's a relation which is love, affection, again, combination, which is not separable. Okay? Like into like a wedding note. Similarly, I send another message. Master Toastmaster, Master Toastmasters, all the members are inextricable. So, again, that combination is proving its always inextricable. It's very good. Today's table topics master is, as I mentioned, Toastmaster Rashid. Rashid, Toastmaster Rashid Amal, can you explain about your role today?
Jobless, all of a sudden I lost my job.
my wife was carrying when I got this job, and I worked very well. Even ignoring her, I sent her back to my country for giving birth to our child. Now, yesterday morning, I got a baby boy, and evening, I was terminated with an immediate effect. I don't know what I should do. He was literally crying. So, the gentleman here, John, he did not pacify me, but he told me, it's okay to lose job. My time is so strong. What do you know about what you are doing there? I was doing a purchaser. What do you know about purchase? Okay, then he started telling about his flight was moving, and they reached the destination. By that time, he made a perfect interview. And when the flight landed, jokingly this man said, sorry, you made everything what I know about purchasing, and as if you are interviewing me for some position. And he said, you know whom I am? I am the zonal manager for a big company. Okay. Now, I did an interview, and I found that you are sincere, you are eligible for my position, for my purchases. And soon you will get the mails from us for you. So that shows that number one is you should not be desperate even after a bad day. Anything can change by any time. Number two is even though he lost his job, he got a better job with better authority, better proximity with his boss. So things are happening for good. Take it in positive. Whatever happens, it is happening for good. Thank God for that. Third thing is perform your best whenever you get a chance. God knows, maybe my future will do something.
Caring, and after comes the office, she will treat
cup of coffee. And even the husband shouts at her, she understands, she replies very polite manner, smiling. And the second time, is one everybody has. First question of the evening.
You know,
fellow members, I'm warning you. Fellow members, and my valet, good evening. To keep the husband and wife's bond inextricable, you need to give a gift to your spouse. But for the Indian husband, it is very easy. Buy anything in gold, your wife will be very happy. But unfortunately, my wife doesn't like it. Now you may be thinking, okay, he is lucky chap, he did not spend on gold. But she has got many other things which sometimes it is more expensive than the gold. One of our liking is the dresses. So this year I thought, every time we are giving the gift, this birthday I have to give her something surprise, some surprise gift I can give her, like that I thought. Because every year I used to give her birthday gifts. Some of you may be knowing that how to remember, especially for the birthday, that how to remember life's birthday. If you forget once, you will never forget again. That's what they say, but I never dare to forget even for once. Because I can't work without remembering her birthday. Because my computer's password is her birthday, so I can't. So I thought, okay, what to buy it for her. Now, as I said, she has spot on dress. Because we are three at home, myself, her, and her son. We have three wardrobes. And in her wardrobe, she has got her dress. In my wardrobe, I have my dress. And in son's wardrobe, he has got his dress. In my wardrobe, it takes only 20% of the space, my dress. Rest of the space, it takes my wife's dress. Similarly, my son's wardrobe, it takes around 25%, and rest is my wife's dress. Whenever we go out, she will tell, okay, let us go out. She will open her wardrobe, then we'll search for the dress, and she will open my wardrobe, then she will search for the dress, then she will open my son's wardrobe. Then she said, Rajesh, I don't have a dress to wear. And I used to tell, so many people, this time over last time when we went there, this whatever, this color doesn't suit her for me. What about this? This same dress she has got, I can't wear this one. Whatever, this was last time you bought from the club. So why you order for this? You did not wear this so much. No, when I went there, my friend also went there, she also bought the same kind of dress. So she is coming for this party, so I can't do this. So you may be thinking, okay, as a surprise gift, I can buy her a dress. But the dress which I choose, she doesn't like. So there's no point in giving her the dress which she doesn't like. So I thought that is not a choice. Now, what to do? Go on a friend. So I called my friend, this is the situation, I want to surprise my wife with some gift. Let me ask him what she is. Okay, how about the handbag? You know this lady's handbag? So we have so many things in that. If you search for something, you will never get it. Sometimes when I go to the shopping, I used to give the house key to her to keep in her bag. After coming back, I used to ask her to open the door, I used to ask her the key. Then she will start searching. I am she gets the key. I used to think breaking open and entering the house is much easier than searching the key in her purse. So anyway, the purse is the better thing. I thought from where to buy. Now anyway, it should be something branded, something good. Anyway, so I got in Dubai we have that outlet mall. You'll get the branded item for the cheaper price. So on Friday I went along with him to Dubai. And I went to this outlet. And when you enter, anybody has been to the outlet mall there?
Yes.
When you enter first time, first of all, district patent registration.
Yes.
So I entered the first district. There was the VP suit for sales person was there and he was there was a beautiful yellow color I got there. It was written as HERMIS. Hermes. So I asked can you show that Hermes tag? Then he said, he did not bother to take the tag off. So they told what kind of bag? Because I was wearing some jeans and old t-shirt. He said, there are some good bags that are available in the next shop. I thought, okay, what he is telling is correct. And while coming out of the shop, I thought he wanted to move me out of the shop. I got a little insulted. And I asked my friend, why he told that there is a next shop for that good bags? And he said, did you check the price tag on that? And yes, it was some 250 dirhams. Oh, it is not 250, it was 25,000. No, it was 2,500 dirhams. And I thought, okay, better he show me out. So he came out of the district. Then he told, that is not Hermes bag, it is AB bag. Because it is a pension district, they call it as AB. It is a big designer bag. It is spelled as HERMIS, but it is pronounced as AB. And I realized, the pronouncing the bag is the first pre-qualification to buy the bag. That's why he drove me out. Then he came out and then the next shop was a female lady was there. She was asking me who you want. I told her what my wife had to do. So she was showing some good bags and all. Finally, I purchased one good bag for 250 rupees. Then I came back home, I kept it there to the wardrobe without telling her on the D-Day came and I gave her. I told her that I wanted to surprise you for this, right? I'm gifting you. And she said, she opened the bag, surprisingly, she was very happy with the bag. Because I have never expected my selection, she will like. She was very happy and she was looking inside and all. And finally, there were so many pouches like for the lipsticks and the small mirror for the face powder and small everything. There are different pouches and for the mobile also there was a pouch. Then this pouch for the mobile, she was telling, oh, I'm having this Samsung Note Pro. This doesn't go in this one. Actually, I think this is sticks for the iPhone 7 pink color one. Anyway, you wanted to surprise me. Why can't you buy one iPhone 4 pink color with 128 GB memory?
Okay. You know, to deliver a prepared speech even if I commit for one prepared speech for 2 weeks time, but apply should be there in the rest of the taking up an impromptu role is very easy, but taking up the challenge of delivering a speech. And that will be, you know, Kamal is an inextricable attribute inherited by Toastmaster Rajesh Palikare. Another round of applause. Yes, we have a timer. Can you just tell me the timer?
Toastmaster Rajesh Palikare took 8 minutes 20 seconds. The time allotted is 7 minutes 30 seconds maximum. So this is destroying our time.
And then I'm going to voting is not applicable today, one speaker. But he deserves all the 100% of today. Let us quickly move on to the evaluation. I would invite, let me call the speaker once again to announce the timing code for the evaluation.
The time allowed for evaluation speech is 2 to 3 minutes plus or minus 30 seconds. At 2 minutes, I will show the green light. At 2.5 minutes, I will show the yellow light. And at 3 minutes, I will show the red light. And the speaker is finished his speech. Okay.
Thank you. Let me invite Toastmaster Dinesh to validate the speech.
Good evening once again to Toastmasters, especially to Toastmaster Rajesh Pankare. Today, considering that Mr. Rajesh Palikare has agreed it out of a sudden to make a speech, that too in an ACB level speech, which is very difficult that we can make people laugh. And he agreed for that and he ventured for that. So I thought, why I can't dare like him. But he succeeded and I am struggling. The whole the speech was entirely different from this original version. The original version was a little bit emotional and he added spices into that and made it a different delicacy now. The, as you have seen, his hand gestures were more prolific this time than before. What it is that the hand gestures like this, exhorting this, and accepting this, and insisting this. This way, he did not exhort Baba Rajesh. That is good, fine. But only his movement in the podium is also was, we can see, we could see that how he entered, etc. It was clear from his expression that what the shopkeeper denied to give him and how he felt. It was clearly seen. But saying all these things, one thing I noticed now is few sentences you are making it abrupt. You are not carrying it out. You conveyed it. The message is conveyed, but sentence is abrupt, which you need to work on. Then audibility here in this room is little bit different. We need to work on that, because when we were speaking there, I thought that it is maybe because of truncated roof, but not like that. Here also we have the same effect. There is not echo, some disturbance is there. Echo is also there, but added to that, some disturbances. No, they are also same. It is not about AC, not about external sound. Yeah. Okay, so that is the only comment I have to. Otherwise, please give me a big applause for having that applause. Thank you for making me as the best graduate.
Thank you, Dr. Sundaresh.
Self-proclaimed.
Yeah, self-proclaimed. We know today. See, that's again another quality of consciousness. He can make everything out of nothing. Coming back to my IoT, Internet of
Things.
IoT, it has certain inextricable components, four components, as the master finished out. Hardware, software, data, and service.
Okay.
We need to cover that. Anyway, the term internet is there. Internet, in our general convention, what is internet? Because it is a network of connecting computers.